Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to release a video series about file handling in C++. In this video session, I am going to explain you the introduction about file handling in C++. Before moving to our topic, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks, keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification about new channels, new videos. Now let's start with the file handling. What is file handling? Before that, we'll go for what is file. So files are nothing but the storage where we can store our data permanently. And a file handling is nothing but a mechanism which is used to perform different operations on it. So, with the help of file handling, we can perform different operations on a file with the help of streams. So, what are the streams? So, streams are nothing but the abstraction which are used to perform the input and output operations. The streams are used to perform different input and output operations that I am going to explain you in detail in this particular slide. So there are two types of streams. The first one is input stream. Input means from where you are getting the input. You can take the input. So you can take the input from a keyboard. That is with the help of ifstream. The another one from where you can take the input are nothing but the files. So whenever you want to take the input from files, you have to use the ifstream. So the input stream, you can take the input from ifstream and ifstream. The another type is output stream, where the output goes to the screen using ofstream, and the output can also go to the file using ofstream. The same thing I am explaining one by one in the consecutive two slides. So what is input stream? Where you are taking the input either from the keyboard or from the file. Using what? So using ifstream and ifstream respectively. Ifstream, who takes the input or who is useful to take the input from the keyboard, and ifstream, who is useful while taking the input from the file. This slide I am going to explain you about the output stream. So output stream, who is responsible to give the output. So ofstream and ofstream, these are two output streams. Both are responsible for respectively output to the screen and output to the file. So ofstream is responsible to give the output to the screen or onto the screen, and ofstream is responsible to give the output or to write the output onto the file. Now I am going to explain you these stream classes in again another some different way, like the streams which are used to perform the operations, who uses keyboard and the screen. They are ifstream and ofstream respectively. Together, the ofstream is the library or a header file that you are going to use in the C++ function, where cin and cout you are going to use to take the input from a keyboard and to show the output, to write the output onto the output screen respectively. In the same way, in the same manner, if I want to perform the same operations on the files, then what I have to do? So with respect to that, whenever I want to use the file, at that time I have to use the IF stream who performs the input operation and OF stream who performs or who is responsible for the output operation. Together, IF stream and OF stream uses the class or the library or a header file is nothing but the fstream. So these are the streams which we are going to use further when we want to use the files or we want to perform the input and output operations on the files. Next slide, I am trying to explain you how these streams, file input output streams, are useful while performing the operations on a file, or other way around, I can say that while file handling, how to use these streams. So now let's start with the files. Let's consider I am having a file with me and I want to perform a read operation on that file. So I will read the data from the file with the help of input stream, means IF stream. So input stream is helpful if I want to perform the I want to read the data from the file. So after reading the data from the file, I will send this data for the processing to the program. This program will perform some processing on that data, and this processed data I want to write again back onto the files. So to perform or to output this data, to write data onto the file, I have to use the output stream. Is nothing but the OF stream. For your information, I have again written all the things in this format. Like if I want to perform input, I need to use the IF stream. So input stream is nothing but the IF stream who is responsible for the reading purpose. Whatever the read data is there, I will send it to the program who performs some processing on that, and processed data is ready for the writing. Now who will take the responsibility to write data back to the file? So the output stream is nothing but the OF stream will take the responsibility to write data onto the file. So this is nothing but the writing data back to the file. So this process is performed repeatedly, that is from the disk file, read data with the help of input stream, send it for the processing, processed data I want to write with the help of output stream, and it writes data back to the disk files again. So this is nothing but the file input and output stream who performs the operations in this particular cycle. Reading data, processing, writing data, read, write, read, write with the help of input and output stream respectively. These are the two major or main functions or the operations that we are going to perform onto the file with the help of file handling with input stream and output stream respectively. Now next, the important part in this introduction is nothing but a file pointer. What is file pointer? So file pointer is nothing but which is helpful to perform all the operations while handling the file. Mainly if or when we are going to open a file for any of the purpose, for example reading or writing operation, a file pointer is maintained. Who this file pointer maintains the which file on which we are going to perform the operation. So always associated file pointer is used to perform all the operations with respect to that particular file. I'll explain all these things in detail with the help of example. So for that you need to be stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. So now file pointer is useful for the keeping the track of the current position into the file. Where currently you are performing the operation, for that the file pointer is useful because it helps to keep the track of the current pointer, current position into the file. And whenever you are going to perform the reading or writing operation, automatically the file pointer is get advanced or incremented. We, the programmer, don't need to operate or we don't need to increment it, because automatically it is get advanced to the next position into the file. So in this way, with the help of file pointer, we are going to perform different operations, for example reading and writing onto the file. Now, which are different opening modes in which we can open a file? So this table is explaining you about different opening modes. So these are the modes in which we can open a file. These modes are stands for what? And what is the explanation about these different opening modes? We'll see one by one. So first one is in mode. It stands for the input mode, where if I want to perform the input operation, that is the reading operation, at that time I have to open my file with the ifstream into the input mode. So mainly this input mode is used for reading purpose. The output mode, IOS out, is nothing but the output mode where we are going to open a file to perform output operation, that is for the writing purpose. For this I need to use the OF stream with which I can perform the write operation onto the file. Next one is APP, is that stands for append mode. Here it is useful for appending the data onto the output file. Now here, whenever I want to perform the read operation for which my file must be created or it must be exist. If the file is not existing, then I can't perform the read operation or the file will not get open. But if I want to create a file, for this output mode is useful. With the help of this output mode, I can create my file if the file is not available, file is not created. But if file is not created, then it creates a new file. If the file is created and by mistake if you are giving the same name, then it overwrites the data and it opens the file as the new blank file. But if already file is created and I want to keep my previous data as it is, and if I want to add some more data onto my file, in that case I have to open my file in this append mode, where it appends data to the end of the file by preserving the previous content in that file. Now these are the opening modes. Now here, if I want to go to the end of the file when it will get open to perform say different operations, for that I am having the mode that is ATE, is nothing but at the end. So with the help of this mode, the file pointer will move automatically at the end of the file. The another mode is binary. If I want to perform the operation on a binary file, then I can use this mode where data file will get created and you can perform the operations on the binary file. Truncate is the another mode, for which the short form is TRUNC. It stands for truncate. It discards the content of existing file when opening for write. So as far as our requirements are concerned, we need to identify in which mode we want to open a file, and accordingly after opening a file you can perform different operations. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. For further contents of my video, you can Go through the next video for which I am providing you a shortcut link over here. Here I am providing you a playlist for the same video series, and here I am providing you a subscription link. Please do subscribe my channel and stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Thank you.